Hello and welcome to another replay cast of the recent Clan Wars series. Today, again, Islands of Ice. Oh no, not again, because it's the first time I feature it, I think. Against a really, really good team, against OM. I think OM is running like two or three teams at the same time, so there are slight differences. I didn't notice. I think there are different lineups depending on the FC, I guess, so they have some versatility in it. And we are just facing the one that has a Kurfürst, which is surprisingly. Don't know if you can utilize a Kurfürst that good, but I guess OM, or at least this particular team, thinks you can, so why not, of course. Then double Des Moines, double Hildenburg, Sau, and one Gearing. While we are running our standard setup of Des Moines, Hindenburg, double Hindenburg, Sau, Gearing, Yu Yang, and the Montana. Is there anything else to say? Yeah, I'm heading towards this position down here. Ah, yeah, and also I'm going to feature it because it shows if you are playing against one of the best teams, or currently they are the leader in of all the clans in the Clan Wars season, so they are in the first place. How to act against them. And for example, OM is a team, they will play, if you have the point lead, then they sit back like we do, and if they don't, they play aggressively, and I think that's the thing that but it's remarkable. They do it quite well, in my opinion. So even we are not as good as they are, in my opinion, yet. And yeah, you will face, or we will face something like that, because we get an early point lead, or we get a point lead, and yeah, then you see them push. Alright, so I'm going in this position here with my Des Moines, Hindenburg, Montana are covering me. The Gearing is in front. He got chunked down by the enemy radar, I guess. And reverses back into the cap. While our North group, consisting out of Yu Yang, Hindenburg, and Sau, are progressing over to B to check out what's up here. And if so, they might aggressively push. Normally you don't want to shoot without cover or without being spotted, but I'm doing exactly that right now. The same the thing in the Des Moines, because I'm hidden. And that's always the thing. Of course, you can't sit in a stationary position and shoot while you are spotted, because then the Des Moines will get chunked down really, really quickly. So always have that in your mind if you're playing Des Moines. So now I'm spotted. That means immediately danger for me. And you see this area here. The battleship is able to shoot through it, so I make sure I'm reversing as quick as possible. And I'm also a bit lucky that I don't eat anything there. Could have gone wrong. So I'm reversing behind that island and get safe. The one that was spotting me was that Hindenburg. So I have to go silent to not eat too much damage. Alright, now I'm unspotted again. It's fine. Meanwhile, we achieved to cap C. And we have now a better clue what is down here, but there are still missing two ships consisting out of the Gearing, the enemy one, and I think it is one Des Moines, yeah. One Des Moines is also missing here. So these guys are probably shelling this Des Moines that is already upset because he gets unlucky with the fire RNG, it looks like. I'm also radaring since I know the DD is contesting, but the DD has this right, this good spot here, which favors always the eastern side of the on this map, because because it's hard to reset unless you have a DD that is, or anything else, maybe something that is in this area up here, maybe a Des Moines or so. Then this position is really vulnerable. But from down here you won't be able to shoot as much because you have to like push until here maybe, and then he has to be forced to go in front. So that's usually not going to happen. I'm taking shots on the Des Moines again, because I'm not spotted and I'm relatively safe. Of course you could also use the DD to smoke you up here, but since I don't know where the enemy Des Moines is, I'm a bit unsure where I can smoke and so on and so on, or where the smoke is should be situated. I guess the Des Moines is somewhere here, but as I said, I'm not 100% sure. Our gearing couldn't spot him yet, and meanwhile it looks as if he ate a random torp, or not a random torp but a torp, which is unfortunate and gives the enemy some HP advantage. But on the other hand, we killed their Des Moines up here, which gives us a ship lead and a 100 point lead as well. The thing is, this point lead is going to be obsolete sooner or later because we only have one cap, but our Yu Young is working on it and capping B while these guys are really pushing hard now, focusing that Hindenburg and force them away while the Tsar is trying to help out. Yeah, that's basically it. So in this case we have a pretty good position points wise and ships wise, and I think OM is sooner or later forced to do something about it. Okay, keep on channeling without being spotted. Yeah, get blind fired, which is expected, but since I'm behind an island, and if you are behind an island and not spotted, you can't be shot at reliably, unless you have a spotter plane or something, because that island, if you can't lock down, or lock on a ship that is behind an island, because he's not spotted, that does mean that the shells will land in front of this island, which makes it, yeah, you just saw it. The first one shell was going out when it was locked, and the second one, the Kurfürst vanished and my shells immediately went into that island right in front of me. But also, I noticed, okay, they put the Kurfürst here to dig me out, and probably the Hindenburg, maybe even a Des Moines is coming to challenge me. So, yeah, that's gonna be uncomfortable for me sooner or later. Meanwhile, our Hindenburg is in an awkward position because he's reversing. Normally, I think I wouldn't recommend. I'm radaring just for information. And we lose our gearing, I guess, to radar or spotting or something like that. Our battleship is also in trouble, it looks like, because he got chunked down or ate a torp from the enemy gearing. But yeah, as I said, this Kurfürst is approaching, and I need to help out my Hindenburg, so I have to go in front sooner or later and use my DPM to help chunk down that Kurfürst. And what else comes out? Yeah, I realize it a bit too late, so now I should be able to shoot. Of course, I'm at a huge risk. The shells of every tier 10 battleship can overmatch my nose and also citadeled me, and that's why the Des Moines is always winnable really bad against like battleships bow on. I mean, of course, if it's chunked down like this, if you would have been full HP, I would be so worried, because then it's really likely that I go down sooner or later. But I make sure that I'm staying cover, so that Hindenburg can't shoot me. And always when he's like showing a bit more broadside, I'm switching to AP. My aim wasn't that good, as you saw, just overpens or bounces. I tried to aim for the for this line here, superstructure. I'm switching back to HE. Our Hindenburg is going in to present another target. And meanwhile, the Moin approaches from back, which is quite worrying, because it means I'm forced to go even further in front. Alright. Hindenburg is going to challenge me, and we most likely lose this guy. Yeah, our Des Moines, our Hindenburg is going down. So now I'm trying to do my best to get rid of that Hindenburg as quick as possible. I switched here to AP to knock out the turrets, but I have to say I'm not really successful at it. I get a good volley into his superstructure, but I think I should have stick a bit more and I repair, because I'm most likely going down, but I want to stay alive as long as possible. That's why I repaired. So he's coming close, but I should be able to delete him before he's getting out his torps. So next volley is AP, and look where I'm aiming. And I hit a citadel there. And that's really, really important, because you can citadel and Hindenburg in the close quarters if you aim for the front turrets, or in front of the turrets when he is at a 45 degree angle. Then you can actually citadel Hindenburg in close quarters. Or you get lucky in the battleship when he's completely nose in, like totally only nose in, and you overmatch his nose and are getting pens right into the citadel. Alright, yeah, we took down that game. I think I played it quite well there. Some of our moves are improvable. I mean, gearing eating a torp there was quite unfortunate, and yeah, some other minor things. I'd like to, well, our Hindenburg that was covering me to my right should have like bailed and maybe getting into a kiting position when he had the time to, but he sadly didn't. It's fine if I die sooner or later, but for those who watched the commentaries on Islands of King of the Sea finals, I'm there as a, like a threat for the DDs and locking down the cap, but I'm okay with going down if the enemy has to pay a huge price for it. Means if I go down, at least two ships should go down, or at least one should go down, and another one should be like chunked down heavily. So that's, you always want to trade in this situation favorable. And yeah, that was the case. We took out the Kurfürst, we took out the Hindenburg, and we had enough points to win at that point. And yeah, it's all that easy. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and see you next time. Bye bye.